It's Harjeet, a certified Pilates instructor with Fit Armadillo. I'm here today to show you three different exercises you can do with the stability ball. These exercises are great for runners in particular because they're going to help you strengthen your core, your hips, improve your balance, your posture. They're great as cross-training exercises or even as a strengthening workout. And it also will help you prevent injuries, which are really important, and achieve those faster results that you're looking for. Okay, let's get started. So we're gonna do the first exercise, which is called short bridge. You just lie flat on the mat, rest your legs on the ball. Open the arms to a V. Palms can be flipped up just for a second to let the body settle. So here, the spine is neutral. We have a little bit of space under the low back so you can slide a thin piece of paper underneath. So just rest here, relaxing through the arms, the shoulders, all the back muscles while still maintaining your neutral, letting the legs sink into the hip sockets. And then keep softening your legs all the way to your toes and just stay there and breathe. So as we take an inhale, try to send that breath to our hips. And then let the exhale be easy, softening through the sternum. And again, let's take that breath in, down to the hips. Expanding the back inside of our rib cages as well. And then everything softens, fingers, legs. And get heavy on the mat. Let's take one more breath in. And then exhale, soften. Sternum is soft. And from there, make a smaller V with your hands. Palms can face down. Walk your feet so that they're flat on the ball and that your knees are directly over your hips. So again here, we really want to keep the pelvis neutral and keep our core, our deepest abdominals engaged. So from here, just go ahead, you can go ahead and engage your triceps to press your upper arms against the floor, but keeping the shoulders soft, that's really important. So just make sure that you're looking up ahead. And then from here, press gently into the heels and start to roll your pelvis, your rib cage up into a shoulder bridge, until you arrive in neutral spine. So tailbone is pointing down towards the floor. And then from here, just check in that your back muscles are soft, your chest is soft, shoulders are soft, and you can keep pressing with the arms. And then soften through the sternum, roll yourself back down, keeping your chest soft until you arrive at the neutral. Again, from here, we engage first by rolling the pelvis, press through the heels, engage the glutes, find your bridge at the top. Breathe here and soften through the sternum all the way to the bottom. Just articulating through all parts of the spine, completely releasing through the legs and glutes at the bottom. So let's just find our bridge one last time. Just taking our time to roll, pressing evenly through both heels, reaching the knees away from you. And then from here, if it's good for you, you can start to roll the ball slightly away and then bring it back in. So from here, we're going to keep the pelvis at the same height, and it's just the knees moving further away from you and then coming back in. So let's do that two more times. You're really going to feel the hamstrings working. We want to make sure that both hip bones are up high and level, so we're not dipping down there on one side. And then you stay at the top, breathing here, and then let that exhale soften the sternum, keeping our shoulders released, rolling through all parts of our spine. And then just relax the legs over the ball, keeping the pelvis neutral. Just kick your legs a few times. This will massage your hamstrings, give you a little break before you move on to the next exercise. And try to stay soft in the arms as we do this. Okay. So for the next exercise, you can roll to the side and come up to sitting. So we're going to do rolling like a ball, Pilates mat exercise, but we're going to do it with a stability ball. It's very important that when you're doing this exercise that you don't turn your head and look at the video. Or just watch the exercise first and then try it on your own. Always looking either straight up in the ceiling or in front, and that's going to help protect your neck. The other precaution for this exercise is that if you have disc herniations or osteoporosis, or you're at risk for it, please don't do this exercise. Okay, so let's get started. So we have the ball a little bit further away from us. We sit up tall, and if that's hard for you, you can just allow the knees to dip out, especially if you're gripping in the hip flexors. So I'll just move my arm out of the way. So from here, let's just roll the pelvis until we have a C shape with our spine. So the shoulders are soft. And then bring the ball closer to you. The legs are going to be parallel to the ground. Feet are pointed. Hold the ball just under your legs and lift it up without losing your C shape. So we want to maintain that C shape, staying curled in the spine all the way from your tailbone to your head. And then while looking forward, to stay there, press the ball with your legs and think of the heels reaching towards your sit bones, and that's going to help you stay upright more. So really thinking through a lengthening through that spine and just breathing. And then if you're ready, we can go on to the full exercise. So for here, we take a breath in, and then as we exhale, we sink deeper into our low abs, roll, oops. Let me catch myself now. And then find our balance point without dropping. So it's really important when you roll back that you only go up to the tip of your shoulder blades and not your neck, and that you do not lose the alignment of the head. So I'll do it wrong just to show you. So this, or that was too much, so that went on my head, or letting the head bounce off the ball, or sorry, the floor. So from here, we stay at the top, we breathe. Legs are actually going to feel really good. Just keep breathing, holding, reaching longer through the toes, sitting up taller, pressing the ball in into your back of your thighs, and then slowly lower the ball to the mat while maintaining your deep abdominal engagement. And then let the ball go and just shake out the legs, rolling them side to side in the hip socket. Okay, so that exercise really works the abdominals, the inner thighs, and the exercise before, the short bridge. It's all about working the glutes and the hamstrings. Okay, so I'm just going to adjust the camera. So our next exercise is standing. Oops, I've lost the ball. So let's keep the ball to the side just for a couple of seconds. Stand with the feet hip distance apart. We're going to practice balancing on one leg and then lifting the other sideways. This is going to work all your side hip muscles and your glutes. And then also for the supporting leg, it's going to work all the deep stabilizers of the knee. Even your feet will have to make all these little adjustments to keep you upright. And then of course, working the spine to stay really tall. Okay. So I just want to draw your attention to your nose. You can imagine you have a straight line that goes from your nose to your sternum, your breastbone, through your belly button, your pubic bone, to the middle of the pelvis. So that line shifts. Let's start by shifting to your right side. So the pelvis just and the shoulders, they just slid directly to the side. So from here, we stay really tall up the spine, keeping both sides of the waist long as we start to lift that outside leg up, and then slowly let it come down. Don't let it dump down. Okay, let's repeat that on the other side. So we shift to the side, keeping that little square, the shoulders and hips even, press through that supporting foot, keep that knee pointing forward, lift up through the spine as the leg slides along, lifts up, keep the knee pointing forward. This is gonna help you balance, and it'll start engaging the glutes. And then stay here for just a second, checking that your shoulders aren't going up, you're not gripping with the arms, let everything be soft, really using your abdominals and your spinal muscles and the sides of your legs to lift you up And then slowly get longer with the leg to come back down. Okay. So now we've practiced the basic leg position. Let's add the ball to it. So the full exercise is actually holding the ball, arms above our head, with the arms straight. So I just want to draw your attention to the shoulders. So we don't want the shoulders up by your ears. Let them slide away from the ears, along the rib cage, as if you're trying to slide them into your back pockets. And then the second thing of note is if you know you round your shoulders a lot, I want you to open up your chest. So your collarbones are wide, your shoulders are melted down your back. And then the other is that we want to make sure that our spine is neutral. So the arms can lift up either at our ears if we can keep our shoulders down or just slightly in front. We find that hip distance position, pelvis is directly forward, abdominals are engaged. So let's start by shifting our weight like we learned, keeping that line pointing down. Reach up with the arms, slide that leg away, and then start to tip onto your side, really pressing through that anchoring foot. So allow your ear to tip as well towards the bottom arm. Reach long, keep the abs engaged, and slowly get taller, reach longer with the arms, shoulders to melt as you come back down. Find center. And then shift to the side, press through that foot, reach long, and then tip to the side. And then just check that you're not bending the bottom arm. Really reach the arm long. This is going to be a great strengthening workout for the arms, not just the abdominals and the hips. So get taller. The ball's going to start to feel lighter if you do enough of these. Just repeat one more time. So slide the hips to the right. Reach long with the arms. Start to lift up with the leg. Just checking that the knees forward, tip to the side, reach long, stay there for a breath, softening through the shoulders. You might even be able to bring the arms slightly back now, and then get taller as you come back. Last one on the other side. Shift, lift, and then reach long. And then the other point is make sure that your leg's not in front, not behind, that it's in line with your arms. Or should I say, your torso. Oops. If that fits you, don't worry. Just pick up where you left off. And then really reach long to come back. And then lower the arms. Shake it all out. Put the body by your side. And then just pause. You can even close your eyes for this bit and just notice how your body is feeling right now. Just notice where you're feeling engagement, where it feels a little bit lifted. And then you can open the eyes, just shake out the arm, shake out the legs. And hopefully your body enjoyed this workout. You feel energized, even though it was quite a strengthening workout, and that your posture feels a little bit improved. So this is a great cross-training workout for runners, even if you're a beginner to Pilates, to fitness.
Thank you so much for watching this video. We really hope that you enjoyed it. But we have no way of knowing unless you give us a thumbs up on YouTube or leave us some feedback. So please do so. And let us know what you would like to see more of here at Fit Armadillo. We always love finding ways to help you enjoy fitness at your own place and pace. You can find more videos like this one and more tips on our blog. So please head over there where you can also continue the conversation. Let us know what you thought about the workout once you try it. But if you have a form question or want some more help in a more personalized workout, we hope that you will book a private session with our amazing instructor, Harjeet. You can find her booking calendar at fitarmadillo.com/Harjeet. Here at Fit Armadillo, we specialize in private fitness sessions provided over live two-way video chat, so you can really enjoy a workout no matter where your busy life takes you. Make sure it's efficient and effective, and we hope you'll check us out. Thanks for watching. See you next time.